This Saturday marks the 12th annual Blue Ribbon Bacon Festival. Channel 13's Maria Lizignoli joins us now. She's over in the other studio. She's got some guests there to tell us more about this latest rendition to the Bacon Festival. It looks like Brooks Reynolds is there with her as well. Good morning to you all.
Good morning. Yes, it's the face of bacon himself.
Yes.
Brooks Reynolds.
Good morning.
We're here talking about the 12th annual Bacon Fest. It's been going on for so long now, and it's a hit. 11,000 people came last year.
That's right.
What continues to bring people back?
Well, I think everyone loves bacon, and you know, we are fortunate that Iowa is the home of, you know, the number one state producer of pork in the United mm-hmm. States, and we've got great pork. I mean, we've got, you know, Chef Dom and 20 plus food vendors that have 50 plus unique menu items. We have 6 different bacon companies that showcase their bacon. We have over 100,000 slices of bacon.
Oh my gosh.
You know, one of the things, you know, that brings people is a bacon Bloody Mary. You
gotta, yeah,
you,
oh,
you
yeah,
gotta wash
obviously.
The bacon down with something. But you know, this is Jones Dairy Farm bacon. They're actually out of Wisconsin, but they 80% of their hogs
85% of their hogs are from Iowa.
Are from Iowa.
Oh wow. But
it's a fun thing. You know, we change our event every year because mm-hmm. if it's the same event, then people aren't gonna come back. So we have different themes, and this year is Hello Piggy. It's a celebration of the 60th anniversary of the Iowa-Yamanashi sister state relationship. So it is an Asian theme. So we have Asian flavors. We have a lot of Asian dishes that are there this year. You know, like Cafe Fusion, which is on this on East 14th. Mm-hmm. They've got, you know, bacon rangoons, bacon pad thai, bacon fried rice. There's so many different, you know, unique bacon menu items mm-hmm. there.
Bacon is, I feel like, super trendy right now. And Chef Dom was saying that over in Japan last year for their Bacon Fest, they just loved it.
Oh, it was a huge success. You know, yeah. In 1960, we sent over 36 hogs for relief effort and 100,000 bushels of corn. And when I found that out, I was like, well, we should do a bacon festival over there. Mm-hmm. And it hit. It was a great success. We actually had to get shut down a little early because of a typhoon. But, you know, Dom and I have been going over for 2 years. We're going back later this year for the 3rd annual Japan Bacon Festival. We actually have 10 people coming over from Japan that are coming in this week. Chef Shino, she's unfortunately not going to make it today.
Yeah.
But, no, it's a lot of fun. You know, everyone loves bacon. It brings vegetarians back from the dark side.
Actually, Chef Dom was talking about bacon-wrapped tofu, which totally defeats the purpose, but that sounds awesome.
It was a lot of fun last year with that. I can't wait to see what Chef Shino is going to make up this year.
Yeah, exactly. These are some popular things. We tried the, what are these again?
The Super Bacon Balls.
What are these?
Those are bacon-wrapped ribs.
Okay.
A favorite for many years at the festival.
Award-winning.
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 Two-time award-winning bacon-wrapped ribs.
What are people, I mean, how do you fill this massive event center, literally top to bottom?
Well, we've got a lot of activities inside the Iowa mm-hmm. Event Center. We take over the entire building. We have 4 levels of bacon excitement, as we like to say. You know, the main floor is the food vendors. We have 20 plus food vendors. Then you get into the theme bar area where we have kind of the, you know, fun areas. We have a dojo where there's a sumo wrestling area. We have a karaoke bar. We have a silent disco.
Huh,
if you haven't
yeah.
been to that, it's similar to Hush, so that's downtown. And then on the top floor is Club Sizzle. We actually have a, you know, nightclub, day club. DJ Mr. Black is coming in from Minnesota. He's the Minnesota Wild and Minnesota Vikings
okay,
DJ.
Yeah.
So, you know, you got to kind of work off the calories.
Right. It's a little give and take.
That's right. So you got to, you know, do a little dancing. It's a fun day. You know, it's a one-day festival,
yeah.
so it you have to experience the whole thing. So you have to walk and you have to, you know, be mobile and you know, go throughout the entire building. Actually,
exactly.
Andy is the MC of the entire event, so it's great.
That's right. Andy will be there. It is this weekend from 10 a.m. till 5 p.m., right?
Yes.
Right about that?
Mm-hmm.
Tickets, you can buy them at the door. $27.50. Early admission is $53.
Yeah, and really, they've done a good job of opening up more tickets to this event, expanding the event. And for years, they just really had a hard time getting everybody into that event that wanted to attend it because there just wasn't enough space. But the Iowa Event Center is a place that has
yes.
Kind of all the space in the world. So everybody is able to go in there and they're able to add all of these new things each year. And really for chefs like Dominic, the other great chefs of Des Moines, it's a great challenge to those guys, right? To take something like bacon that's very versatile and let them just kind of work their magic and alchemy and spin that in a million different directions. And it's obviously great for those of us that like to eat, too. So.
Right, exactly. I was just kind of eating while they were talking. So.
I see that. Yeah, you're supposed to save a little of that for the rest of us, Maria.
Right.
All right, thank you very much. We're looking forward to that.